Now, we have a couple of words for Yiddish Word of the Week.
Ooh. Oh, we're just straight into it, Yiddish Word of the Week.
Well, we, you know...
We haven't got time to waste.
We've got a busy show this week.
We've got a busy show. But we've got... But we'll discuss... We're talking about settlers that came here. So the Yiddish word is... Bazetza is a settler.
But, you know, really, were they settlers?
That's right. The question is, when they came here, the first fleet, were they settlers?
They didn't come willingly.
They were runaways.
Bazetza means settler.
They were sent away.
Bazetza is settler, first of all. Yeah. But you're saying that's not the word?
It is the word.
It is a word.
They didn't come voluntary to settle. They were sent here, correct?
So they came... Because what Australia is, historically for us, and for a lot of Australians, I suppose, is Zwitser.
Penal?
It means jail.
Penal colony.
Not penile.
Okay. That's where you had me. I was a bit confused.
Penile.
Didn't know where it was going.
No. Yeah.
So that's the word tfisa in Yiddish.
Yeah. And they came to this beautiful, lush country, which then brings us on to...
The white brown land.
No, it doesn't bring us to the white brown land. It brings us on to Tubishvat,
which is now... Okay, the birthday of trees.
3rd of February, isn't it?
We have a Green Sunday on the 3rd of February.
JNF.
Fate Wiseman, and they're looking for...
Volunteers, and what a great cause.
To raise money.
Is that what they... 3rd of February, I'm
because they want to collect money...
We're not sure.
To grow trees.
To grow more trees for Israel.
It's called the Chag Ha'ilanot, which is the birthday of the trees.
Yeah.
So they need volunteers to help raise money.
Yeah, because you can't see the Jews for the trees in Israel. I personally have donated 15 million trees in my life.
Really?
5 million on my bar mitzvah alone.
They're a lot cheaper back then.
If I go to Israel and there isn't, it's completely inundated with forests, I'll be very disappointed.
I want to mention a bit of history.
Apparently, there's a lot of
canyons. For all those who are watching and wondering, actually care about the First Fleet story, there was, I think, about 6 Jews who were convicts in the First Fleet, and one of them was a gentleman by the name of John Weishammer, who was arrested and charged with stealing a snuff box. And sent to Australia. So he has a story here, as do 6 Jews on the First Fleet. So there's a Jewish link there with the motherland of England. And they were all convicts.
So
no aristocracy there.
We're not all European.
He was innocent, though, wasn't he?
We're not all Polish, Polish and Hungarian and Russian wogs.
We're not?
No.
Now you tell
me. Some of us go back
a few
more
generations.
What's the other one? Oh, so we've got Tfisa and the settler, and that's, you know...
And that's about it.
They came here and they stayed.
Then we've got something added.
What are we going to do now? Speak to some expats who are living here now and ask them what they think about Australia Day and how it's relevant and relative to them or for them.
So we have an American, an Israeli...
And a priest walk into a bar.
Yeah.
And
then after the break,
come
back with Henry, because we'll be gone already because we've had enough.
Yeah.
And then there's some other stuff. And then
music
we'll see
good.
You next week.
Yeah.
And there's some music at the end.
More, but don't go away.
Well, you're going to come back, but it's goodbye from me. Goodbye from you.
Yeah, goodbye from me and goodbye from you.
Meh.
Oh, no, you'll come
back.
We'll
see you.
So far on the show, we've discussed Barry Eva and my point of view for Australia Day, but why not bring some other members of the Shtick family onto the couch and find out from them what it means to be in Australia on Australia Day, considering that Terry is American, Eitan is Israeli, and Russell is English. Hi, guys.
Hello.
Hello.
Now, let's start with you, Terry. As an American living in Australia for how many years?
20 years now.
20 years. You've come from nationalistic America, where your flag waving is an honourable thing to do. What does it feel like to you to be in Australia on Australia Day?
Well, that's interesting. The view is really, what's it like to be in Australia on the 4th of July? Because the 4th of July in America is a really big deal, whereas Australia Day in Australia is not nearly so patriotic and so nationalistic as the 4th of July is, even though the celebrations are very much the same. They come at about the same time in the year, in the summer, towards the end of the middle of the summer. The weather's the same, there's barbecuing, there's fireworks, there's all kinds of stuff. In Australia, it's like a big party. And in America, it's really very patriotic, and even more so than it was when I lived there.
When, as an American, on 4th of July, do you look at foreigners in a different way? Do you think to yourself, wait a minute, I'm an American, you're not. Whoa, should you be here? Because I'm an American.
Well, I don't think so. That's not how I feel like that. Right. I mean, it's a much more multi-ethnic culture here in Australia.
Yes.
And you really feel that when you're in Australia. There's people of all different ethnic backgrounds are very proud of that background. Mm-hmm. And that really comes through in their lives in Australia and on Australia Day, really.
Gotcha. Thanks, Terry. Eitan, Israeli, living in Australia. You have Yom Ha'atzmaut, which is Independence Day, which is a beautiful time to be in Israel and a very joyous time, also a solemn time. as all ceremonies are, as all simchas are in Israel. But tell me about for you in Australia, what's it like?
It's a good time to take a holiday. Yeah, it's a couple of years ago.
Yeah.
It was like midday, I had a coffee with a friend, got pissed off that I have to be a long weekend over here, took a flight to Hobart, 3 days in Tasmania, it was fabulous. I really enjoyed it. It's fabulous.
But we have a holiday here now. Would you stay in Victoria?
When in Victoria? Yeah, actually going to do some kind of shooting in Myers Bowl.
Okay. That's film shooting, not gun shooting.
I hope so.
Okay, good man, good man. But do you brought up in any sense of the feeling of, the pride and the feeling of love coming from the heart or the thinking from the head, being here? Does that get to you at all?
Well, the thing I find really hard actually is to cope with the alcohol.
Okay.
Because at one point, I just have to drink so much to match everybody else around me in Australia Day.
Yeah.
So, but the barbecue is the same, you know, the same idea of the barbecue and, you know, all these kind of things.
Sure.
The alcohol is still a bit hard for me.
Okay, keep trying and good luck.
I'm doing my best, but it's hard.
Good luck. Yeah. Rusty, English, Russell Sayer, what's it like for you?
I don't know, really. I mean, doesn't feel any different from any other day
Do the English have a nationalistic day?
This is it. I was just hearing what Terry was saying, and it's completely the opposite. There's no Great Britain Day. There are no days where everyone runs out into the street and goes, "Hey, Great Britain," and all. Don't let anyone tell you anything else, and it's brilliant and all this. You don't get any of that. So when I see all this Australia Day, this day, that day, it's like...
Are you a bit embarrassed?
No, I'm not embarrassed, just a bit sort of warm by it, I suppose.
Warm, did you say?
Warm, as in...
Oh, like,
warm.
Not again, they're going off, they're mouthing off about the country again, big deal, we colonised it, and your country, and your country, and your country, that's...
But I didn't colonise it.
I actually got you the first
Colin,
time.
Colin, was it Colin? Maybe Colin was the...
Yeah. But so, there's nothing in England, but you're here now, can you get swept up in the fervour? Walk around with a flag as a cape, pointing out people's differences?
No.
No.
Not really, no.
Good man.
I mean, why should I? I mean, how can I?
Really? Which one? Why should or how can?
Well, how
I can
I?
Answer both.
How can I? But that brings back to the original question that you asked me.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, it's... I don't feel like any of that sort of thing. I don't wake up in the morning going, "Whoa, today I feel Australian."
You just don't. You're not a convict.
But, I mean...
Anymore.
Yeah, anymore.
But I mean, the convict business, I mean, how long ago was that?
Yeah.
It's like, Australia, get over it, all this. Whenever I'm out on the street or whenever I meet people, you know, yep. And they always have this jive about all the convicts.
Yeah, but isn't that part of your English cultural cringe?
It's part of a certain English cultural heritage,
just
not mine.
That's right. We're all pointing the finger.
We're talking about the 1800s, and then it's 2008.
The whinging palms.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, the same sort of thing.
I don't want to have to divide you on the couch. It's getting a bit rowdy.
It's a conversation, though, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Let's get Russell.
Yeah, well, it's great. I'm impressed with the responses because they are three vastly different opinions. The three of you are now in Australia, so all I can do is wish you a happy Australia Day, and I hope you understand that Australia is a very lucky country because we are able to have different opinions without the feeling of, that you're going to be thrown into prison or attacked or killed. Still, I think that's still the per case. I'm not sure.
I thought you need to have a criminal record.
Boom, boom. Oh, yeah. That's rough enough for me.
What I did in Leeds.
What did you do in Leeds?
I can't tell you that.
Okay.
It's true that Australia is a lucky country, and one of the nicest things about Australia is Australians don't realize really how lucky they are. And so in that sense...
What do you mean by lucky? In what sense?
In how blessed the country is and how calm it is. How easy it is to live here, things like
this
that.
This is true. It's a very easy life here.
And,
it is very easy.
And because Australians don't really understand exactly what it's like to live in other countries, even when they do go overseas and live there for a while, that doesn't spoil them. I mean, they're not precious about the way the culture here
but
is.
But don't pet their ego too much.
No ego petting.
No chance.
That's a great point to end up on, gentlemen. Thank you very much. Great opinions. Thank you and happy Australia Day.